Earphone required. Earphone required.
Honda Center. First time in my life I've been here. Qua cổng kiểm soát an ninh nó thấy mình tự lem đeo đầy người, nó bắt lột ra hết. So now I go.
Enjoy right here. Help
okay.
You.
Thank you.
Ticket. Wait. Got it.
Wow.
What happened?
Because I have a lot of things. They asked me to take off everything. Wow, incredible. Wow. Incredible.
What?
Incredible. First time in my life I've been here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Yeah. So.
Okay, you stay here.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. You want anything?
Thank you.
Come on.
I'm gonna put here.
Okay, I sit here. Go.
What?
Okay, so, you go. I play. Yeah.
Wait. Come back down here. Get the verses.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah, we will have a lot of time to do video and teacher. Taken.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so we were at 207G14.
Okay.
This is 207. This is 206.
Okay.
And
all right.
So we're right here.
No, that's all.
You ate?
Out here. Thank you.
Hi.
So I'm one of those four actors that brought Swanee Vegan to your church.
Wonderful.
They shut it down.
It's wonderful.
So we've been planting seeds to our Buddhist friend here.
Yeah. Hi, how are you?
The Vietnamese military and they imprisoned him for a year and a half as a POW and escaped here.
Wow.
So all his children are now Christians, and he's the last one there.
Yeah.
So we
well, listen very close tonight to the words of God.
Yes.
Not me.
Yeah.
Jesus' words.
My daughter know you.
She does.
Her name is Han Yin.
Han Yin?
Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah, are we going to
do a picture? You want to do a picture?
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, Pastor Jack. So we've been speaking of the Board of Education. We've had victories last
yes,
night
gonna,
and the other
we're,
night.
We're going to see more.
Till midnight last night.
1, 2, 3.
God bless
yes.
you. Thank you for standing.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you.
God bless you. Sir.
And
thank
when you told us to go to Sacramento for the unborn,
yeah.
we were there too.
Yeah, thank you.
Good. Everything captured right here. Vietnam right here.
Vietnam.
Yes.
Hey.
Australia. Okay, that's
further.
Welcome.
That's
pretty
welcome.
Far.
That's awesome. Perth? Where are you guys from? You got, you're going to have to pass the location down. States where people are now beginning to wonder, what do we do about people not desiring to go to school on campus anymore because they want to be a doctor or an engineer or whatever, you're now going to be politically indoctrinated, right? By so much. And so that's not what you sent your kid to go to school for. So no matter what, you want to make sure that your child is grounded in Christ Jesus and the Word of God. And that's not just Sunday, that's every day of their life. And so it's up to them to seek out the truth. There's a lot of truth givers out there. But you gotta find them.
Vietnam.
Vietnam.
Of course, it's not getting easy these days. But I don't know if you guys know this, but last Wednesday night at church,
Yeah,
in that moment when we wake up as believers. Notice that if you're a Christian tonight, or a Christ follower, as I like to put it, if the desire for Jesus is truly in your heart, the first thing that happens in the morning is that you get up and you think, Lord, what are we doing today? It doesn't matter how predictable your day is. The question of the believer is, Lord, what are we doing today? But maybe tonight you've come, and maybe this is the first church service you've been in a long time. And God might be saying to you, where are you? In these amazing days in which we live in, where are you? Luke chapter 15, we'll read two passages tonight. Luke chapter 15, and then I'm going to jump over to Revelation chapter 2. Luke chapter 15, the Bible tells us Jesus is speaking. Then all the tax collectors and the sinners came near to Jesus to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes complained. That's the professional religionists. And they said to him, this man receives sinners and eats with them. So Jesus spoke this parable to them, saying, what man among you, having 100 sheep, if he loses one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which was lost, and he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and his neighbors, saying to them, rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost. So I say to you that likewise, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 just persons who need no repentance. Revelation chapter 2. To the angel of the church at Ephesus writes these who, according to the scriptures, say to us, he who holds the seven stars in his right hand, who walks in the midst of the seven golden lampstands. I know your works, Jesus says, your labor and your patience, and that you cannot bear those who are evil. And you have tested those who say they are apostles and are not, and have found them to be liars. And you have persevered and have patience and have labored for my name's sake and have not become weary. Verse 4, nevertheless, Jesus said, I have this against you, that you've left your first love. Remember, therefore, from where you have fallen, and repent, and do the first works, or I will come upon you quickly and remove your lampstand from its place, unless you repent. But this you have, that you hate the deeds of the Nicolaitans. Church, the Nicolaitans were those, again, professional religionists who governed over the people. They controlled the people in the name of religion. And Jesus said, which I also hate. He who has an ear to hear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. And to him who overcomes, I will give to eat of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God. Father, bless the going forth of your word, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated, everybody. Both of these passages of...
Thank you, Jesus.
Well, have you read the Tibetan Book of the Dead? First of all, why would I read a book about the dead? When Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life, why would I do that? So listen. I'm past my time. We've let it end. Here it is. Time is up. Think of it this way. I'm going to ask you tonight, as a Christ follower, be careful regarding this invitation. Ask yourself if you should stand to recommit your life to Jesus, if you should. Because number one, if you're not serious about recommitting your life to Jesus, then do not stand. God knows our hearts. And we'll be tempted to lie in front of a lot of people just to blend in. Don't do it. It's just us here tonight. And many of us will not see each other again until we're in heaven. But tonight, as a follower of Christ, I'm asking you to think about if you should stand. If you're not a Christian tonight, I hope that you watch us and you look at us and you follow us like a hawk, constantly watching us. If you have Christians in your life and you're not a Christian, you ought to watch the friends and family members that claim to know Jesus, and at the end of about 30 days of watching them, you'll know if they're Christians or not.
Amen.
But I gotta tell you, no matter how that goes, put your eyes on Jesus.
Come
Start reading John's Gospel. Your life will never be the same. And so I'm going to ask you to pray. I'll pray, you can think about it. But then I'm going to lead you in a commitment if you want to do this. Father, in Jesus' name, we pray right now, Lord God Almighty, that if now, tonight, out of all of this crowd tonight that's here, there might be one person. Out of this so-called 99, there's one that's being found by you tonight. You're convicting them, you're speaking to them, you're saying to them, you need to come back to church, you need to come back to the family of God. You need to forgive people, you need to set it right, and you need to come back with the joy of the Lord in your heart. You need to recommit your life. Your heart has grown cold, you've left your first love, and you're not excited about me anymore. You know who you are. If tonight that is you, heads bowed and eyes are closed, I'm going to ask you, if you are going to recommit your life to Christ and not look back, I'm going to ask you to stand in silence right now. Just go to your feet. If you're going to recommit your life to Christ, and by doing so, you're not going to go back. You're not backing up. You're going to go forward. If God is speaking to your heart, this is a service of recommitment. Maybe the Holy Spirit is speaking to you tonight, saying you need to publicly acknowledge me, that you're going to be my disciple. You should stand to your feet right now if that's you. I'm going to ask you, if you're standing, to pray this prayer with me. I'm standing. If you're a follower of Christ tonight and you're walking with God, why don't you say this with us? You want to say this out loud? I'll say it. You can repeat it. Almighty God and Father, I come to you in Jesus' name. I pray to be led by your Holy Spirit and that you would forgive me of my sins, the sins of my family. Please, Lord, forgive me of my anger, of my resentment, and my missed opportunities. I come to you in Jesus' name, asking you, Father, to save my husband, to save my wife, to save my son and my daughter. Please, Lord, save our grandchildren. Save our neighbors. Dear God in heaven, I call upon you to destroy the strongholds in my life. Deliver me from my addictions. Forgive me for not trusting you. Cause me to see you as the Lord of my life. Put your fear in my heart again. Renew me, Lord, to do your will. I confess you, God my Father, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, and Holy Spirit, to whom I yield completely. Tonight, September 8th, I recommit my life to Christ, and I'm not going back to this world. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Listen, we're going to end in worship, but before we do this, I'm going to ask you, I'm going to give you marching orders right now. This is the main part of the event, frankly. There's a QR code that you should, I can't see it. Can you see a QR code? There's a QR code there. We're going to want you to grab that QR code. Can you do that right now? Listen, relax, do it. We don't want your money. It's not going to ask for anything. You're safe. Get that QR code because we want to give you marching orders. And here's what they are. want to give you the opportunity on how to find a church. We're going to give you 10 biblical instructions on how to find a New Testament church wherever you might live in your area. All the information is there to make tonight continue on in your life. This may be one night, but it's a night of starting over again. It's a night of renewing your love for Jesus. And by the way, if you leave before worship or at the end of worship, there's Bibles that are available for you to take at the exits of this building tonight if you don't have a Bible. But dear friends, we want to tell you tonight, we love you. Jesus Christ loves you. This whole event was born out of me looking at congregations, wondering, where are the people we once used to recognize? Where'd they go? And the biggest thing that came back to us was fear. God has given you a spirit of a sound mind through the scriptures. We need not fear any longer. Let's stand together. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, I pray that you bless all these that have taken the time to come tonight. And God, I pray that your spirit would fall upon these, and Lord, that there would be a move in this place and in this Southern California, in this state, and in this nation, that should time allow, we could mark the epicenter that it began here on September 8th, right here in Southern California. We ask you in Jesus' name.
Going up.
Right, you're doing good. You're doing really good. That's talent.
Jesus is King.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Did I see something like that? Signs of parents.
Have a good night. See you Sunday. Come Sunday, you get some football.
I saw.
Thank you.
kill him in the world, so you want to make
sure he's not killed. Yeah, this is for you. This is you get a Bible today. Chuck Smith's New Testament Bible. Free gift for you.
What you read is there?
Huh?
Has been edited by iMovie Lord.
Lamb Tram.
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
Có tóm một diễn tham.
Càng nghe nhiều càng tèo, 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 tèo.
Ta tiên linh, sư đoàn
ngây ngựa. Càng nghe nhiều càng tèo.
Quan càng to, cua càng teo mo.
Thằng lính dù nào nói khi nhảy dù chim không teo, thằng đó xạo.
Mà đa số chúng nó nói xạo thiệt.